welcome to Narc Abuse No More, where we're here to help you admit what you feel in order to heal from the effects of narcissistic abuse, because your feelings do matter. Here is your host, Dr. and Evangelist K.L. Rich.
Hi, welcome to today's podcast of Narc Abuse No More, where we're here to help you admit what you feel in order to heal from the effects of narcissistic abuse, because your feelings do matter. Yes, they do. But before we go on with today's podcast, I'd like to invite you to visit us on our website at www.narcabusenomore.org. Again, that website address is www.narcabusenomore.org. And on our website, you'll find valuable information regarding narcissism, relationships. And if you have missed any of these podcasts, all you have to do is go directly to our website and listen to us from there. Now, just to let you know, we are on every Monday at 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 9 a.m. Central, and that is on SoundCloud, iHeartRadio, Spotify, Spreaker, Google Play, iTunes, CastBox, and Deezer. We're also on Amazon Audible, Rumble, Brighteon, and the Tube. That's right, we're on YouTube. So you have a variety of different platforms that you can listen to us from, but if all else fails, all you have to do is go directly to our website at www.narcabusenomore.org. Now, those who are my SoundCloud listeners, I do not always upload onto SoundCloud. They was connected with Spreaker, and I don't know what's going on with that, but anyway, that means I have to upload individually, so I may not always upload to Spreaker, but you have a variety of other platforms that you can listen to us from if it's not uploaded onto Spreaker. All right, what are we talking about today? We are talking about depression. Yes, depression. There are a lot of things that are going on, that's going on all around the world that causes people to be depressed, whether it's a loss of a loved one, a loss of a friend, loss of marriage, bills, just life, period. You know, there are various things that can cause people to be depressed, low self-esteem, different kind of issues. And so a lot of times veterans are suffering from depression, and the suicide rate with veterans is, I believe it's like 17 per day or something. I'm not sure. I might have those stats wrong, but it's way too high. And sometimes people take their lives because they feel hopeless. They feel like there's they've lost interest in the things that they used to enjoy. They're irritated just by being around other people. They're very hard on themselves. Maybe they feel like that they didn't accomplish in life what they wanted to, or whatever the case may be. And if you are experiencing depression, guess what? You are not alone. Now, you know, there's times in life when we will often maybe have irritability or low self-esteem or other issues that may cause us to have feelings of sadness. If someone that you love passes away or whatever the case may be, you may experience depression. That is normal. Okay, that's normal. But the difference is when the depression lingers for a long period of time, or you're just having trouble just getting back into the swing of things as you used to. It may cause problems in your relationships where they may suffer, or on your job, or you might not be performing on the job as you used to. Your focus may be off. You may have trouble just seeing the positive in life anymore, things that you used to do, take joy in, rather it was some type of physical activity. You might have wanted to or used to hunt, or used to go fishing, or used to paint, or whatever the case may be, and you lost total interest in doing those things, then you may be dealing with depression. Again, a lot of veterans deal with depression because they lost someone that was maybe close to them, or they lost a buddy in war. We need to, as a thing about veterans, pray for those that's in the military, because there's been some recent casualties in the military. It can cause those who may have known those people, they may have been your buddy or your comrade, or just even hearing about it, you may not have even known them, that it can cause depression. So depression is a serious thing that people deal with in different ways. But one thing I do want to let you know is that if you are having signs of depression, please do not struggle alone. Talk to your doctor. Tell your doctor that you are dealing with some things, and they might send you, to a counselor. Or sometimes if you go into a psychiatrist, they may prescribe some medication. Make sure that you check out the medication, because sometimes even those have side effects. So you want to talk with your doctor about the side effects, so it won't be doing just the opposite of what they really hope for it to do. Go to a support group. Talk to a friend. Talk to, if you're at the church, if you can talk to your pastor, talk to someone so you are, you do not have to feel like you are alone. Because depression can interfere with your daily life. It can interfere with your ability to function naturally. It can interfere with just your overall mindset, where everything is gray and the sunniest of skies. So just make sure that you talk to someone and don't deal with it alone. Again, there's various things that can cause people to feel depressed. A lot of elderly deal with depression. Women are more prone to depression. Service men and women sometimes deal with depression. Veterans deal with depression when it comes to death of a friend, or maybe they're getting ready to retire or transitioning. If you're a veteran, transitioning back into the civilian life after being in the military. A lot of times women, after they have a baby, they can deal with postpartum depression. Financial issues can cause depression. So there are a lot of things that can contribute to depression. And one thing that is so important to know is that it is treatable. It is treatable. But there are some things that you should know about depression. Is depression can hurt. Okay. It can hurt you physically and hurt you mentally as well as spiritually. You might be a person that, you have this relationship with God, but then even those in the Bible, sometimes they got depressed, such as Elijah. Elijah had just won this victory over Jezebel and her idolatrous priest. But the thing is that he went into this this bout of depression, and so he wanted to die. So depression can hurt. It can manifest even in younger people. Don't think that just because someone is young, they don't go through depression. You have a lot of times teenagers that deal with depression because they don't fit in. They feel like, I don't fit in with anyone, or they might be teased by others, or they might feel awkward, and so therefore they can deal with depression. Again, women are more prone to depression than men. So they're twice as likely to be diagnosed, should I say, than men. Men may not go get the help that they need. And if you're a man, you're dealing with depression, please get the help that you need. You need to also talk to someone. Women go through depression. Their hormones fluctuates. Dealing with menopause. If you're going through that menopause, I know I'm there right now. And peri after a year, then, I'm dealing with that right now myself. So your hormones can change or whatever can cause you to go into depression if you're dealing with menopause or if you're in perimenopause. Stress can cause you to go into menopause. Taking care of, all the responsibilities in life, dealing with children, dealing with family, dealing with elderly, job situation can cause you to go into depression. So again, if you are dealing with that, men, they deal with midlife crisis too. If you're dealing with depression, please talk to someone and get the help that you need. Symptoms of depression can be different for everyone. So whereas somebody might be, they might isolate themselves after the death of a loved one, or they might have a hard time adapting to retirement. And let me just say this, if you've gone into retirement, you find, I'm depressed now that I'm not working, then sometimes people, they find maybe just a part-time or a volunteer something to do so they can still feel as if they're contributing to life. Because believe it or not, as we get older, and we all will get older, there may come a time when you're not able to do as much as you used to do. But then if you find just something, one thing that you enjoy, whether it's volunteering at a homeless shelter or taking an art class or having a group that you maybe go on daily or maybe bi-weekly walks or something like that, so you won't feel like you're alone. I remember the sitcom The Golden Girls. and the Golden Girls, you know, these four women, I'm not sure if they were all sisters, but I believe a couple of them were. But anyway, I'm not sure if they were all sisters, but, you know, they live together. And so if you might say, you know what, I live by myself and I would really like a roommate. And so do some research, you know, if there's somebody elderly or something that, you know, might be in your age group and you just say, you know what, I don't want to live in my house alone. I want to, maybe have a roommate, or I got enough space, you know, just, there's so many things that you can do to try to help with that depression. Again, I recommend talking to your doctor, talking to them and telling them, you know, when are the times that you feel the most depressed, what may have, know your triggers. Is it around the holidays? Is it around an anniversary during the loss of a loved one? Is it a time when you feel like, hey, you know, it just comes on, at the spur of the moment, you know, you don't. So just if you know those triggers, and it could be anything can trigger it. So if you get to know what those triggers are, talk to your doctor about that and say, hey, you know what? Every time around this time of the year, I get depressed. Or because then you could be proactive and your doctor can help you, or the counselor can help you, that support group can help you with being proactive with that. Depression, you know, it can affect your heart. A lot of people have heart disease. You know, they're having heart disease. They're having strokes. It can affect your blood pressure. It does have side effects to it. Especially if you isolate yourself, you're in the house and you're in a dark room and you could close all the curtains and you just don't want to be bothered. It can affect you health-wise. So it is so important to be proactive on top of this rather than having to be reactive after it already happens. If you know that you're dealing with it, then talk to someone. Don't be afraid. Talk to someone. You are not alone. Another thing is sometimes there will be antidepressants and therapy, and sometimes they're combined. So there's different types of therapy that can be done, behavior therapy, cognitive therapy, or whatever that can be done to that the doctor will do, or a support group, or try to help to alter the mindset of how you think about things or approach things and all that. So again, you are not alone, and there are things that can help you. Certain exercises can boost your mood. Certain supplements can help. This one is called, and it starts with an A, and I know I'll butcher it. It's this long name, Ashworth something. I don't know. Anyway, talk to your doctor about it. And I'm not a medical doctor. I'm a pastoral counselor. But the thing is that talk to your doctor about it so that you can know what will work for you. All right, we're going to take a quick break and we'll be back in just a moment.
Touch with my soul. I had nowhere to turn. I had nowhere to go. Lost sight of my dream. Thought it would be the end of me. I thought I'd never make it through. I had no hope to hold on to. I thought didn't know my own strength, and I crashed down and I tumbled, but I did not crumble. I got through all the pain. I didn't know my own strength, survived my darkest hour. My faith kept me alive. I picked myself back up, hold my head up high. I was not built to break. I didn't know my own strength. Oh. Found hope in my heart. I found the light to light my way out of the dark. Found all that I down and I tumble, but I did not crumble. I got through all the pain. Oh, I didn't know my own strength. My faith kept me alive. I picked myself back up. I hold my head up high. I was not built to break. I didn't know my own strength. Mm-hmm. I was not built to break. No, no. I got to know my own strength.
And that is My Own Strength by the late Whitney Houston. And we all have a measure of strength that God has given us. And all we have to do is reach out to Him for that help that we need. I like the verse that says that I will look up to the hills from whence cometh my help, and my help comes from the Lord. All right, so we're still talking about depression. One of the things that's so important when you're dealing with depression is to meet yourself where you are. I want to give you a website where you get this valuable information, www.thehealthline.com, www.thehealthline.com. Meet yourself where you are. A lot of times we try to compare ourselves with other people, and we measure our success based upon the success of others. So you feel like, if I'm not at this point in my life where this person is in their life, then therefore I have failed in life, and therefore you're depressed in life. Let me just say this. We don't have to compare ourselves to anyone, but be who God has created us to be. One thing I like to tell people is sometimes we set, oh, well, by 40, you should have done this, by 50, you should have done this, or whatever the case may be. But the thing is, Moses, when you think about Moses in the Bible, he didn't start leadership until he was 80 years old. Okay, God called him at the age of 80. So he was 80 years old when he led the children of Israel. Joshua was his successor. then lead the children of Israel after Moses had died until he was 80 years old. When you think about others in the Bible, whether it was Elizabeth that was childless, and she had John, and she was way past her age. And different people in the Bible were not where they thought they should be or wanted to be. Abraham and Sarah, when they had, Isaac. So it's not about comparing ourselves to other people. Trust me, that person you may be comparing yourself to might be comparing themselves to someone else. They might, even though they may look the part, man, and you may think that they got it all together. A lot of times those who we think have it together don't. Privately, you don't know their private thoughts. You don't know what's going on and behind the scenes oftentimes. And so therefore it's not good to compare yourself to anyone else. What has God called for you to do? And sometimes, people sprint. I have told this story before when I was in boot camp, and I was never the athletic type. I wasn't on track. I wasn't on any teams or anything of that nature. I wasn't really a sports person. Okay. So that wasn't really in my blood. Okay. So, when I got to boot camp, before I start going, my dad had started training me to jog and run, before I got to boot camp. So by the time I got to boot camp, one thing I knew for sure was that I had to pace myself. If I tried to run too fast or sprint, I was not going to make it. So that would be those of us who would start off running, and some would sprint, and some of them, they would make it. But then some started off sprinting, and then they weren't able to complete the mile and a half that we had to run. And then some, didn't make it at all. They would start and then they would stop. Well, me, I just kept the pace, okay? I kept a pace that was good for me. I didn't care how much my commanding officer was saying, "Hey, Rich, get up here," because that was always, I heard it all the time. "Rich, get up here." I just kept the pace, because I knew that if I did not keep pace, that I would stop and I would quit. So by the time I got done, where some of them sprinters, I would see them along the way, they had stopped and I was still going at my pace. But the thing is, I didn't stop. And then when I got to the finish line, then I would hear my officer say, "Well done, good job." So, the thing is that we don't have to compare ourselves to anyone else but who God has chosen for us to be. And when you do that, then that can also help with depression for those who may be depressed because they feel like, I haven't done this in life. I haven't done that in life. You have people that starting out maybe going to college for the first time at 50 some years old, and that's okay. That's okay. Everyone, there's only one path to Jesus, but everyone has different paths that God puts them on in their life. So there's only one way to Jesus, but there's different paths that people have for their life. What do I mean by that? When I say that is, someone, may have gotten married early and they weren't able to go to school. So then for them, they had to wait until the kids got out the house, and then they finally in their, maybe their late 40s or whatever, and they're just not going to school. That's fine. Somebody else may have gone to school in their 20s and they put off having a family, and therefore they waited until after they finished school and then got married, and then, okay, that's fine. That's their path. So the thing is that whatever God has for you to do, not everyone will have the same gifts. So don't compare yourself. When I talk about different paths, I'm talking about whatever God puts you on to do. If you're meant to go be a teacher, be a teacher. If you're meant to be a janitor, be a janitor. If you're meant to be a cook, be a cook. If you're, whatever you're meant to do, don't compare your path to someone else. Do whatever God has ordained for you to do. Sometimes, number two, to get out of the depression is to consider taking a walk. Go for some activity, some kind of activity. And I'm going to say, whether it's a vacation, whether it's a walk around the block, whether it's a walk to your library, whatever it is, you do something that, you might not be able to always go on a trip, but do something that's exciting for you. It could be going to your local zoo or the museum, or whatever the case may be. Do something that will help to bring down those stress levels in your life. Get up, get out of bed, go out into the sun, sit on your porch. You might not be able to, you might be older, you may not be able to be as active as you used to, but at the same time, you know, get some sunlight if you can. Try to enjoy life. Just wake up in the morning. You might say, oh, I don't feel like getting up, but sometimes you have to make yourself do some of the things that you don't feel like doing just so you can get into the right mindset. Number three, know that today isn't indicative of tomorrow. And what does that mean? That means that just because today might not be a good day doesn't mean that tomorrow is going to be the same. All right. Every day will take care of itself. As Jesus said, don't worry, don't stress, don't have anxiety. Let every day take care of itself. So you know, just because you might be going through a situation today doesn't mean that it's going to stay the same. And those who have unfortunately committed suicide, you know, you don't want to do something permanent that was for a temporary situation. Whatever you think you're facing at 20, trust me, by the time you get 40, it's not going to even be a thing. Okay. and so I've told this story about girls I remember that used to be fighting over these boys in high school. And most of them, if any of them, are not with those boys today. Okay. They're men today. So, you know, it was temporary, doing some foolish stuff that was temporary, and you don't want to do that. So again, don't think that every day is an indicator or today is an indicator of your future. You may be going through some hard times right now, but the Bible lets us know that joy comes in the morning. All right, we're going to take another quick break and we'll be back in just a moment.
Help
And that's Count On Me by CeCe Winans and the late Whitney Houston. And we all need someone to count on. And the best person that you can count on is the Lord. But, you know, God, he does send help down this way. There's a song that Whitney Houston had sang years ago, and it was Help Is On The Way. When you're down and in despair, just believe that he is always there. I think that's the worst one. I think it says, when you're down and in despair, just believe that he'll be there. I'm not a singer, but hold on. Help is on the way. All right. So do the opposite of what the depression voice tells you. You know, sometimes you have that voice that is in your head and is telling you to do all these things that is counterproductive. And don't listen to those voices. You want to do, if you need to talk to someone because you got these voices in your head that's telling you to do these things, talk to someone, tell them that you're, what you're dealing with. Again, talk to your physician, talk to your doctor. Maybe they can recommend you to a counselor or therapist or someone who can help you to navigate that depression that you're in, those thoughts, to have you reboot those thoughts, redirect. Sometimes you have to do, as we do with computers, a control alt delete. And that means that, you know what, I have to reboot my system so that I would not have that virus of negative thinking coming into my mindset. Again, you know what, set goals for yourself, small goals. Don't compare your life with someone else. Whatever, if you want to go back to school, you say, you know what? I didn't complete college. I want to get my associates. Okay, get your associates. It doesn't matter who has a master's or doctor's degree. Get your associates. That's your goal. Once you get that, you might say, I want to go a little further. Okay, go ahead and get that bachelor's degree. You might say, you know what? I want to get a little further. Okay, go for that master's, whatever it is. Set small steps, small goals, small dreams. Whatever dream you have, takes baby steps. If you can't do it, you might not do it all at once. That's okay. Do what you can do. You might be getting ready to go to school and you might say, you know what? I want to take more than one class, but I don't know if I can handle it. And, you know, I just recently told someone, take one class at a time. Do what you can do. Don't try to rush it because you feel like I got to hurry up and catch up to this person. No. Do what is what you are able to do. Where are we at for us? Time? Okay, I'm going to do one more. Another thing is that's good to help with depression is to spend time in nature. Now, in the wintertime can be a little more depressing, depending upon where you're living at, unless you're living in Florida or in tropics somewhere. But, you know, you're in a house or whatever case may be. However, just because it may be wintertime doesn't mean that your house has to be winter. What do I mean by that? Open the curtains. Let some light in. You'll be surprised how sunshine. Come on now. Sunshine. If you know, I don't know if you live in an apartment or whatever case may be, but you know, if you're not able to get that light, then maybe bring some green plants into your atmosphere. Okay. For some people, get you a pet. If you're able to get a pet, I have a dog and two cats. Okay. And trust me, they keep me company. It's like, Tom and Jerry in the house. For those who remember that cartoon Tom and Jerry show. All right. So, if you're into baking, you know, do some baking, maybe give it to somebody or put it in the freezer. You don't have to eat it all the way. Okay. So maybe do something that would bring some joy into your life. It may be winter on the outside, but then it can be summer in your heart. All right. We are up out of here. I pray today's podcast has been a blessing to you and that you will know your feelings do matter. This is Dr. K.O. Rich. Until next time.
We want to thank you for taking the time to join us today on Narc Abuse No More, where we're here to help you admit what you feel in order to heal from the effects of narcissistic abuse, because your feelings do matter. Until next time.